So Gideon's Army premiered last year, 50 years after the Supreme Court decided Gideon versus Wainwright, a case that made clear that we cannot have equal justice in this country if poor people don't have lawyers, the kind of lawyers that you or I would hire for ourselves. And 50 years later, that promise has gone woefully unfulfilled. We have 2.3 million people incarcerated in this country. Almost all of them are poor. They are disproportionately people of color, and entire communities are decimated because they don't have meaningful access to counsel. Now, I started my career as a public defender here in D.C., which is one of the few really well-functioning public defender offices in the country. I wasn't aware at that time about this crisis, and then I went south and worked in Georgia and Alabama, Mississippi, and Louisiana, and I saw criminal justice systems that just processed human beings, that literally accepted an embarrassingly low standard of justice for poor people. And I met these young, inspired public defenders who would go into this work for the right reasons and very quickly have the passion beaten out of them. And soon they would either quit or they would become resigned to the status quo. And so that led to my wife and I starting Gideon's Promise, an organization that recruits, mentors, trains, and supports public defenders in an effort to build a community of change agents to go into courtrooms in broken systems and remind them of our American ideals. Well, we started in 2007 with 16 lawyers and two offices. We will this summer have roughly 300 public defenders from 15 states. And as we were building this, we realized we needed someone to share this story with the country, with the world, and so we started looking for a filmmaker, a storyteller, and we met Dawn Porter. Dawn was a new filmmaker. We invited her to come down and meet our lawyers. We had no idea at the time how brilliant Dawn is. We had no idea at the time how committed she would become to this cause, and we certainly had no idea the impact that her work would have. Dawn focused on three lawyers who are part of this movement, and the result is Gideon's Army. And it has really drawn more attention than any of us ever imagined. You know, in 1963, when Gideon was decided, as a country, we believed in civil rights. We were fighting for it. We believed that people needed to have a fair shot in the criminal justice system. And public defenders were heroes. Defense lawyers were heroes. They were portrayed by our biggest stars. Films like Anatomy of a Murder with Jimmy Stewart as a defense lawyer. Gregory Peck playing Atticus Finch, the quintessential public defender. They were heroes. And now, 50 years later, we've got a criminal justice system that is crueler, that is inhumane, and the right to counsel is disrespected. More often now, you see public defenders portrayed as the stuttering, incompetent court-appointed lawyer in My Cousin Vinny. And what Dawn has done with Gideon's Promise is she has reminded us that we can't have equal justice without public defenders. She's reminded us that public defenders are heroes. She shined a light on the public defenders who do this work and the people that they represent, which is a critical first step to raising our national consciousness and addressing this issue. So it's quite an honor for all of us that her work has received the Ridenhour Award. It's an award that honors filmmakers, documentarians, that address an issue that has gone unnoticed, that serve an important role in promoting social justice. And it's quite an honor that this group of people recognize that that's exactly what Dawn's work does. So before I ask Dawn to come up, I want to just introduce to you a very brief clip from the film Gideon's Army. It gives you a glimpse at the weight that these young lawyers carry on their shoulders, of the import of their work, and of the incredible emotional stress that they carry with them every day. They are desperately worthy of this nation's support, and this award and this film really let them know, and thank you from them, because they know that there's a group of people and a voice that believe they deserve that support. So let's see the film.
The stakes are as high as they could possibly be. I mean, we have cases that haunt us. This case will haunt me. If we lose, it'll haunt me. He is a kid. And he's facing a lot of time. If he's found guilty, it will break him. Mentally, and emotionally. He'll be broken. I can't fathom, I cannot fathom turning around to his mother after a jury has said guilty, and I've told her he's gonna get 10 years, at least, at minimum. She says he's done like a complete 180. He has a job, he's working on his GED, apparently he has this girlfriend. So I think that he's been scared straight, assuming he gets a not guilty verdict and is allowed to live his life. And here's hoping that that's the end result. And we don't see happily ever afters very much in this profession, but hopefully we get us a happily ever after.
See the film. So, Don, on behalf of the hundreds of public defenders of Gideon's Promise, the tens of thousands of people they represent every year, thank you for exposing this civil and human rights crisis to the world. Don Porter.